Hi students, today I am discussing about the topic is chloroplast. Describe the structure of cellulinate that contain chlorophyll pigments. 4 marks important question. Describe the structure of a cellulinate that contain chlorophyll pigments. Chlorophyll pigment containing organelle cellulinate is called chloroplast. It is a spherical or oval shaped cellulinate. Chloroplast is a spherical shaped or oval shaped or round shaped cellulinate, and chloroplast is present in all green parts of the plant. They are present in all green parts of the plant. The green parts like leaf, young stems, next young fruits, and calyx of the flower. These are all green in color. Chloroplast is present in all green parts of the plant. The green parts like leaf is green color due to the presence of chlorophyll pigments, and the young stems are also green in color due to the presence of green pigments, chlorophylls. Young fruits are also green in color. Next, calyx of the flower is also green in color due to the presence of green pigments, chlorophyll present in all these parts of the plant. Next, chloroplast is a double membrane bonded cellulinate. It is also present in roots. Example, T. neophyllum. Generally, in roots, chlorophyll pigments are absent, but the plant like T. neophyllum plant, it is a epiphytic plant. This plant consists of chlorophyll pigments. Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigments, the roots are green in color and perform photosynthesis. Hence, the roots in these plants are called photosynthetic roots. Are present only in T. neophyllum plant. Generally, leaves perform photosynthesis, but in some plants like T. neophyllum, the roots consist of chlorophyll pigments. Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigments, they perform the photosynthesis. Hence, the roots are called as photosynthetic roots. Generally, in roots, chlorophyll pigments are absent, but only in T. neophyllum, chlorophyll pigments are present. Next, it is a double membrane bounded cellulinate. Chloroplast is a double membrane bounded cellulinate. They are surrounded by two membranes. They are outer membrane and inner membrane. Chloroplast is surrounded by two membranes. First one is the outer membrane and second one is the inner membrane. Between the outer membrane and inner membrane, the space is present between the outer membrane and the inner membrane. The space is called periplastidial space. Periplastidial space is present between the outer membrane and the inner membrane. The size of the periplastidial space is about 10 nanometers. Next, inside the membranes, it consists of a colorless matrix. The colorless matrix is called stroma. Inside the membranes, each chloroplast consists of a colorless matrix. The colorless matrix is called stroma. Next, Stroma consists of a flattened sacs. The flattened sacs is called as thylakoid. A single one is called thylakoid. Each stroma consists of a flattened sac. The flattened sac is called thylakoid. Next, empty space. Empty space of the thylakoid is called lumen. Lumen is the empty space present in the thylakoid. This is the lumen. The empty space of the thylakoid is called lumen. Next, the stalk of the thylakoids are pikes of the coins. Many thylakoids in the stroma arranged to form a pikes of coins. To form grana. This is the grana. The stalk of the pikes of the coins. Single one is called thylakoid and the group of the thylakoids is called grana. Next, two granas are interconnected with stroma lamellae. It is also a flat membranous structures. These flat membranous structures connects the two grana. Two grana are interconnected with a flattened membranes called stroma lamellae. Stroma lamellae. Next, inside the membranes, the stroma consists of 70S type of ribosomes. 70S type of ribosomes are present in prokaryotes and 80S type of ribosomes are present in eukaryotes. Two types of ribosomes are present. 70S type of ribosomes are present in prokaryotes and 80S type of ribosomes are present in eukaryotes. Next, stroma consists of ribosomes and circular DNA. 70S ribosomes and circular DNA. Due to the presence of circular DNA in the chloroplast, chloroplast involves self-duplication. Due to the presence of circular DNA in the chloroplast, chloroplast involves the self-duplication. Hence, chloroplast is also called as semi-autonomous. Semi-autonomous cell organelle. Chloroplast is also called as semi-autonomous cell organelle because due to the presence of circular DNA in the stroma, it involves the self-duplication. Hence, chloroplast is called semi-autonomous cell organelle. Next, function. Function of the chloroplast. Chloroplast perform photosynthesis. Chloroplast perform photosynthesis and prepare food material in the form of carbohydrates. This is the structure of chloroplast and it was discovered by, chloroplast is discovered by Sachs. Sachs discovered the chloroplast. And the last one, Schimper, scientist Schimper, he named chloroplast. The name chloroplast is coined by the scientist Schimper. This is the 4 marks bit. Which cell organelle contains chlorophyll pigments? Next, another 4 marks question. Mitochondria or describe the cell organelle called as powerhouse of the cell. mitochondria. It is present in all eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means the nucleus is surrounded by a nuclear membrane. Presence of nuclear membrane, the organisms are called as eukaryotes. Next, the shape of the mitochondria is cylindrical in shape or sausage shape, cylindrical or sausage shape. Next, mitochondria is a double membrane bounded cell organelle. They are surrounded by two membranes. They are outer membrane and the inner membrane. They are surrounded by two membranes, outer membrane and inner membrane. Between the outer membrane and inner membrane, the space is called perimitochondrial space. Between outer and inner membrane, the space is called perimitochondrial space. Next, the outer membrane is smooth. There is no infoldings. Outer membrane is smooth. But the inner membrane is infolding to form cristae. Inner membrane have infoldings. The infoldings are called as cristae. Next, cristae consists of F0, F1 particles or oxysomes. Each cristae consists of oxysomes or F0, F1 particles. F0, F1 particles are present on the cristae. Next, inside the membranes, it consists of a colorless fluid. The colorless fluid is called matrix. Inside the mitochondrial membranes, it consists of a colorless fluid is called matrix. Inside the matrix, it consists of 70S type of ribosomes and also contain circular DNA and some enzymes. Matrix consists of 70S type of ribosomes, circular DNA and some digestive enzymes. Next, due to the presence of circular DNA in the mitochondria, mitochondria also involves self-duplication. They also involves self-duplication. Hence, mitochondria is also called as semi-autonomous cell organelle. Semi-autonomous cell organelle. Chloroplast and mitochondria, both cell organelles are semi-autonomous cell organelles because due to the presence of the circular DNA. Next, inside the F0 F1 particles, some respiratory enzymes. Respiratory enzymes are produced in the F0, F1 particles. Next, function. Mitochondria involves aerobic respiration. Mitochondria involves aerobic respiration. Thank you. the presence of aerobic respiration, the potential energy is converted to kinetic energy, and energy is stored in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Energy is stored in the form of ATP. Hence, mitochondria is called as powerhouse of the cell, because the potential energy is converted to kinetic energy and energy is stored in the form of ATP. Hence, mitochondria is called as powerhouse of the cell. This is the structure of mitochondria. Thank you.